Good morning, everyone. So in the last class, what we did, we were solving for a three-dimensional problem, which is a heat conduction problem. One dimension, it is a transient problem, and the temperature is varying as a function of x, y, and t. And we have made the system non-dimensionalized, and we have set up the boundary conditions also in terms of the non-dimensional variables. Now, in today's class, we'll be going ahead with the complete solution of this problem. So, let us write down the non-dimensional version of the governing equation and the boundary conditions that we have already left in the last class. So, del theta del tau is equal to del square theta del x square plus k square del square theta del y square, where k is equal to a by b, and a is the length in the x direction. So, x is basically lying between a and 0 and a, and y is lying between 0 and b. So, this is the governing equation, and all x star, this is basically x star square and y star square, where x star is equal to x over a and y star is equal to y over b. And later we set up the boundary conditions as well in the non-dimensional term. Tau is equal to 0, theta is equal to theta naught, and x is equal to 0. We have theta is equal to 0. At x is equal to 1, we had theta is equal to theta 1 0, and y is equal to 0, we have theta is equal to theta 2 0, and y is equal to 1, we had theta is equal to theta 3 0, where this theta 0, theta 2 0, theta 1 0, theta 3 0, they are the non-dimensional temperature, and their definitions were theta naught is equal to T naught minus T naught 1 divided by T naught 1, theta 1 0 is equal to T naught 2 minus T naught 1 divided by T naught 1, and theta 3 0 is equal to T naught 4 minus T 0 1 divided by T 0 1. So, now if you look into the original problem, in the original problem we had 5 sources of non-homogeneity. By virtue of being non-dimensionalization, we have reduced the one non-homogeneity, and now we are dealing with 4 non-homogeneities. So, this problem has to be divided into 4 sub-problems, because there are 4 sources of non-homogeneities in this problem. 4 sources of non-homogeneity. Therefore, theta has to be broken down into 4 subproblem: theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4, and then each such subproblem will be considering one non-homogeneity at a time. So, each subproblem we consider one non-homogeneity at a time. So, let us define the subproblem theta 1 and going ahead with the solution. So, theta 1 will be del, the governing equation of theta 1 will be del theta 1 del tau is equal to del square theta 1. So, basically we are substituting theta is equal to theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 plus theta 4 in the governing equation and collect the similar terms, and then we will be getting the governing equation of each theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3, theta 4. So, del square theta 1 del x square. So, now I write x star and y star as x and y, they are the non-dimensional variable, k square del square theta 1 del y square. So, I just substitute x star by x and y star by y, understanding that now x and y will be representing the non-dimensional variables x by a and y by b. So, the initial condition will be tau is equal to 0, theta 1 is equal to theta naught, at x is equal to 0 and 1, my theta 1 is equal to 0, and at y is equal to 0 and 1, my theta 1 is equal to 0. So, so in this sub problem theta 1 we have kept non homogeneity in the initial condition intact, forcing the other non homogeneities on the other boundaries to be equal to be zero, we will force them to be homogeneous. So therefore this is a well posed problem, a parabolic one and three dimensional. Okay, so we go ahead with the separation of variable type of solution. So theta 1 is equal to function of time multiplied by function of x, function of y. So therefore if I substitute in the governing equation, this becomes x y dt d tau is equal to t y d square x d x square plus t x k square d square y d y square. So I divide by t x and y, so what will be getting is 1 over t d t d tau is equal to 1 over x d square x d x square plus k square by y d square y d y square. Okay. So this left hand side is a function of time only, the right hand side is a function of space, they are equal, they are equal to some constant. This constant has to be a negative constant in order to have a non-trivial solution. So now let us look into the special varying part. So 1 over x d square x d x square plus k square by y d square y d y square is equal to minus lambda square. Now we see that the boundary conditions in x directions are homogeneous, boundary conditions in the y direction are homogeneous. So we will be having standard eigenvalue problem, independent eigenvalue problem in both x direction and y direction. So now let us solve the x varying part and y varying part. So d square x 1 over x dx square is equal to minus lambda square minus k square by y d square y dy square, and this will be again this will be a function of x, this is a function of y alone, they are equal, they will be equal to some constant. In order to have a non-trivial solution, this has to be a negative constant, and we formulate the standard eigenvalue problem in the x direction. And the boundary conditions of the original problem in the x direction has to be satisfied by this part. So therefore at x is equal to 0 and 1 we have capital X is equal to 0. So therefore we know the solution of this, alpha n is equal to n pi at the eigenvalues, where n is equal to 1 2 3 up to infinity, and x n is equal to c 1 sin n pi x are the eigenfunctions. So these are the eigenfunctions, these are the eigenvalues. Now let us look into the y varying part. Minus lambda square minus k square divided by y d square y d y square is equal to minus alpha square. So k square over y d square y d y square will be nothing but minus lambda square plus alpha square, and we write d square y d y square is equal to minus lambda square minus alpha square over k square y. So this we call this constant, so we is equal to beta square. So we write it as d square y d y square plus beta square y is equal to 0, where beta square is equal to lambda square minus alpha square by kappa square. So I can get lambda square is equal to alpha square plus beta square kappa square, and at y is equal to 0 and 1 capital Y will be equal to 0. So these will be the eigenvalue problem in the y direction, where lambda square is equal to alpha square plus beta square kappa square, and we know the solution of this. Since it is an independent eigenvalue problem, eigenvalues are beta m is equal to n pi m pi. This m index m is for the independent eigenvalue problem in this particular case. This will be from 1, 2, 3 up to infinity, and eigenfunctions are the sine functions. Y m is equal to c 2 sine m pi y. So, your lambda m n square will be nothing but alpha n square plus beta m square k square. So, this will be nothing but n square pi square plus k square m square pi square. So, that is the definition of lambda m n. Now, we are in position to obtain the solution of the time varying part. So, 1 over t m n d t m n d t will be nothing but minus lambda m n square, and solution of this will be nothing but t m n d tau as a function of tau will be let us say another constant c 3 exponential minus lambda m n square of tau. So, this gives the solution of the time varying part. Now, we are in a position to combine all these three independent three solutions, and using the principle of linear superposition, we can formulate construct the complete solution. If we construct the complete solution, the theta 1, which will be a function of x, y and tau, should be m is equal to double summation m is equal to 1 to infinity, n is equal to 1 to infinity. There will be two summation because we are dealing with two independent eigenvalue problem. So, c m n, this will be multiplication of all the three constants c 1, c 2 and c 3 exponential minus lambda m n square tau sine n pi x sine m pi y, and we evaluate the constant c m n from the initial condition that was at tau is equal to 0. We have theta 1 is equal to theta naught, and theta naught is equal to summation m is equal to 1 to infinity, n is equal to 1 to infinity c m n sine n pi x sine m pi y. Now, c m n will be evaluated as we have done several times using the orthogonal property of the eigenfunction. So, I multiply both sides by sine m pi x sine n pi y dx dy and integrate over the domain of x and y from 0 to 1, and then only in the right hand side only one term will survive when m is equal to n and when you open up the summation series. So, we will be getting c m n is equal to 4, we have done this exercise earlier, 4 theta naught m is equal to 1 to infinity, n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 minus cosine n pi 1 minus cosine m pi 1 minus cosine m pi divided by m n pi square multiplied by exponential minus lambda m n square tau sine n pi x sine m pi y. So, that gives the complete solution. So, c m n will be substituted here, and that will be giving the complete solution of theta 1 part of the sub problem theta 1 out of 4 sub problems that we have defined earlier. Now, we will be looking into the second sub problem theta 2 and see how this solution will be evolving out. So, for theta 2, let us write down the governing equation. The governing equation is obtained when you substitute theta is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 plus theta 4 in the governing equation, and then we collect the equivalent terms in terms of all the terms collect the terms for theta 1, collect the terms for theta 2, collect the terms for theta 3 and theta 4. So, therefore, we will be able to formulate the governing equation of all the four sub problems theta 1 to theta 4. So, for theta 2, this will be del theta 2 del tau will be is equal to del square theta 2 del x square plus k square del square theta 2 del y square. So, at tau is equal to 0, theta 2 is equal to 0, I force this non-homogeneity to vanish in this particular problem. At x is equal to 0, theta 2 is equal to 0, at x is equal to 1, my theta was equal to theta 1. So, we force all the non-homogeneities. So, y is equal to 0 and 1, theta is equal to theta 2 is equal to 0. So, we force all the non-homogeneities to vanish in this particular sub problem, and keeping the non-homogeneity at x is equal to 1, theta 2 is equal to theta 1, theta 1 naught. So, in this sub problem, we will be keeping one non-homogeneity in one of the boundary conditions at x is equal to 1. So, since this in this particular sub problem, it will be having a 0 initial condition, we have to divide this sub problem into two sub parts, one will be time dependent, another will be time independent. So, let us do that. So, theta 2 will be further divided into two sub parts, one will be theta 2 steady state, which will be function of x and y only, and another will be theta 2 tau, which will be function of x, y and tau all. So, next we will be what we will be doing, so this is a mother problem for this sub problem. So, therefore, we are substituting this expression into the governing equation and then collect the similar terms and formulate the governing equation of theta 2 s and theta 2 t. If we do that, we substitute it over there, this will be a function of space only. So, therefore, derivative with respect to tau will be equal to 0. So, left hand side we will be getting only del theta 2 tau del tau, and in the right hand side we will be getting d square del square theta 2 s del x square plus del square theta 2 s del y square plus kappa square del square so there will be del theta tau theta 2 tau and kappa square theta 2 s del y square plus k square theta 2 tau del y square. Then I collect the similar terms and formulate the governing equation of you collect similar terms and obtain governing equation for theta 2 s and theta 2 tau. So, if you do that, the governing equation of theta 2 s will be nothing but del square theta 2 s del x square plus k square theta 2 s del y square is equal to 0. And I will associate, so this is the steady state part, and then we'll be formulating the governing equation of theta 2 tau as well. So, if you do that, then it becomes del theta 2 tau del tau is equal to del square theta 2 tau del x square plus k square theta 2 tau del y square. Now, we associate the non-homogeneous boundary condition of the original problem along with the special varying parts, forcing the boundary condition of the time varying part to be homogeneous. If you do that, and as we have done earlier, x is equal to 0, theta 2 s is equal to 0, at x is equal to 1, we have theta 2 s is equal to theta 1 naught, and at y is equal to 0 and 1, we have theta 2 s is equal to 0. Since we are associating the non-homogeneous boundary condition of at x equal to 1 with the steady state part, in the transient part that will become 0. So therefore, at tau is equal to 0, we have done all these things in detail earlier. So del theta 2 tau will be nothing but the solution of the steady state part as a function of x and y, and at x is equal to 0 and 1, we have theta 2 tau will be equal to 0. At y is equal to 0 and 1, we have theta 2 tau will be equal to 0. So therefore, we will be having a standard eigenvalue problem in the x direction as well as in the y direction. These two are independent eigenvalue problem, and we will be having a non-zero initial condition in this particular case. So this will be a well-posed problem. So this is definitely a well-posed problem, and will be now in the steady state part. The solution of the steady state will be the with a negative sign will become the initial condition of the transient part, but the steady state part itself is a partial differential equation, and if you examine this equation is nothing but an elliptical partial differential equation. Now we have already seen the solution of this. Let us go ahead with a separation of variable type of solution. So theta 2 s will be a product of function of x only and function of y only. So if you put into the governing equation and separate out the variables, then this becomes 1 over x d square x dx square plus k square by y d square y dy square is equal to 0. So we will be and please note that only in the y direction in this sub problem the boundary conditions are homogeneous, not in x direction. So therefore, we will be having a standard eigenvalue problem in the y direction for the elliptical partial differential equation, not in x direction. So we will be formulating a standard eigenvalue problem or Sturm Liouville problem in the y direction only. So let us do that. So kappa k square y by y d square y dy square will be equal to minus 1 over x d square x dx square is equal to minus lambda square, in order to have a non-trivial solution. So if you do that, you will be formulating the standard eigenvalue problem in the y direction, plus lambda square over k square times y is equal to 0. We put lambda prime is equal to lambda by k. So this becomes d square y dy square plus lambda prime square times y is equal to 0, subject to boundary condition at y is equal to 0 and 1, capital Y is equal to 0. So non-homogeneous boundary conditions at y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1, and we all know about the solution of this particular problem. It will be the eigenvalues will be n pi and the eigenfunctions will be sin n pi. So therefore, the eigenvalues will be lambda prime is equal to n pi, where the index n runs from 1, 2, 3 up to infinity, and eigenfunction will be c 1 sin n pi x. Now let us formulate let us look into the rest of the problem, x varying part. So 1 over x d square x n, let us put corresponding to nth eigenvalue dx square minus lambda n square lambda n prime square x n will be equal to 0. So x n will be nothing but c 1 e to the power lambda n prime x plus c 2 e to the power minus lambda n prime x, where lambda n prime is nothing but lambda n over k. So this will be the solution of that. Now we have the boundary condition at x is equal to 0 is equal to x n is equal to 0. So this boundary condition has to be satisfied. So 0 is equal to c 1 plus c 2 So your c2 will be equal to minus c1. So I have the solution of x varying part as c1 e to the power lambda n x, lambda n prime x minus e to the power minus lambda n prime x. If you look into the governing equation, this will be 1 over x d square x dx square, it will be taking on the other side plus minus lambda square x. So it will be not lambda prime, it will be lambda only. So this will be lambda, this will be lambda, this will be lambda, this will be lambda, this will be lambda. So now I divide and multiply by 2. So this x n becomes c 1 prime sine hyperbolic lambda n x. Now I get the solution theta 2 s will be summation of the c 1 prime multiplied by c 1 for the y. So it will be a new constant, let us say c n sine hyperbolic lambda n x multiplied by sine n pi y. So it should be n pi y. Okay. Sine n pi y, and then at x is equal to 0, we have theta 2 s is equal to theta 1 naught. This initial condition was not utilized. So I am going to substitute this initial condition here and evaluate c 1. So if I do that, what I will be getting is theta 1 0 is equal to summation of c n sine hyperbolic lambda n at x is equal to 1 sine n pi y. Okay. So I multiply, I use the orthogonal property of the sine function and evaluate. So theta 1 0, so c n will be nothing but sin hyperbolic lambda n integral 0 to 1 sin square n pi y dy, and this will be theta 1 naught sin n pi y dy from 0 to 1, and we will be having that c n is equal to 2 theta 1 naught 1 minus cosine n pi over n pi. And this will be half. So this will be half, this half will be going that as 2, and you will be having 1 over sine hyperbolic lambda n. So we will be getting a complete solution of theta 2 s as a function of x and y as 2 theta 1 naught n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 minus cosine n pi divided by n pi sine hyperbolic lambda n x divided by sine hyperbolic lambda n, and we will be having sine n pi y, and we know the lambda n is nothing but k times lambda prime, and lambda prime is n pi, so it will be n pi k. So this will be 2 theta 1 naught summation n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 minus cosine n pi over n pi sine hyperbolic k n pi x divided by sine hyperbolic k n pi sine n pi y. So that gives the complete solution of the steady state part, and then we'll be I'll stop here in this class. We'll be looking ahead with this problem and go ahead with the rest of the solution. Thank you very much.